We've been having a little bit of fun, I guess, remembering the last year of the pandemic by noting some of the anniversaries. And the anniversaries really of some of the most outrageous things that were said along the way that sort of set the tone for the pandemic. Got a special one for you today. It is Kenneth Copeland, and he wanted to just end this thing early on. 1 year ago today, we were supposed to be done with this pandemic, as you'll see.
Execute judgment on you, COVID-19.
Oh, Ramos.
I execute judgment on you, Satan. You destroyer. You killer. You get out. We break your power. You get off this nation. I demand judgment on you. I demand. Hold. I demand. I demand a vaccination to come immediately.
Yes.
I call you done. I call you done, gone. You come down from your place of authority, destroyer. You come down and you crawl on your belly like God commanded you when he put his foot on your head in the Garden of Eden.
He sort of like ran out of in the Garden of Eden. Jesus. We have Francesca, right? Francesca,
oh, you my God. See that? I'm so sorry. Are we talking about devil worship?
I think, look, the people in the crowd don't think that that's what they're doing, but I think that's the closest thing to what it actually is. It's not original to point it out. Many people have. There is nobody on the planet who looks more like Satan cast in human flesh than Kenneth Copeland, which you would imagine would be like a roadblock to getting a job as a priest of some kind. That dude looks like he's got demons in his skull. I don't believe in any of them, but I start to when I look into his dead abyssal eyes.
He looks like the, I am so sorry for the internet problems, but he looks like the, who's the snake in the Jungle Book? Is it Shere Khan or the or
Shere Khan's a tiger?
He looks like a Jungle Book character. It's not the snake, but it's he's scary. You know what I mean? Just like
the snake. I think you mean Shere Khan, actually, maybe. It's not even a good performance. Like he was stumbling over it. He can barely move, and he's got that really sad sidekick. Who's doing like a 1/10 energy version of what Kenneth Copeland is doing, because that guy doesn't have demons in his soul. So he's just like holding his hand out like, yeah, demand belly. I like the belly part. Do the belly thing. Oh, maybe it worked. Maybe immediate, like maybe this is as fast as God could do for the vaccinations. He said, I want it immediate. And God's like, how's a year? Maybe we got it because of Kenneth Copeland. Anyway,
I haven't had internet. So like for a brief, honestly, for like 4 minutes, I felt very calm and present.
Yeah, no, you're back into the breach once again. Anyway, the last thing I'll say is, look, there are a lot of good people who have honest religious beliefs in a number of different things. And every religion has its crazies and its extremists, but How does he have anyone in that room? Like I get maybe he's wealthy, he builds the room, he stands there and he shouts, but it should be at empty chairs. Why is anyone sitting in that room and thinking, this guy's got a direct through line to God? The person who created the universe is channeling through this goblin in front of me. And sure, all of his predictions are wrong, none of them come true. But yeah, no, this is the guy I want to give money to.
Do you think Jesus was this obnoxious? You know, like Jesus didn't come down like, I swear to God. Like he was not crazy. He was, you know, I feel like he was soft spoken, sandals, any guy in sandals, you know what I mean?
That's the way they present him, yes.
How were his
toes?
Maybe
it's not honest, I don't know.
I'm curious about the toenail. Did he have toenail hair? Was the toe, were the nails clipped nice?
For Kenneth Copeland? I think it's technically.
Oh no, Jesus. Oh no, I'm not talking about Jesus.
Nail. But anyway, yeah.
So Kenneth Copeland is just turning into a nail.
His whole body. Anyway, that was just a quick little look back at one of the steps along the way of the last year. There will be others and worse, but I happen to remember that one.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.